we first went over the derivatives, we talked about the linearity of a derivative, right? So if you have a function with some constant multiplied and another function multiplied, and if you differentiate, you get to split the addition or subtraction, and any constant multiple can be pulled out, right? So when you differentiate something like this, these a and b go unchanged, and then you only differentiate these functions attached to these coefficients, right? So that's what we observed, and we call this linearity of derivatives, right? Differentiation of derivatives. And because differentiation satisfies linearity, same thing holds for integration. So if you have integration of a function times a constant and another function times a constant, that's same as first integrating them separately. And then any constant multiple can be pulled out, just like when we did it for the derivatives. Okay. So that's called the linearity of integration. So this is the linearity of integration. In a more professional way, people say integral operators are linear. It's a linear operator. Now, derivative operators are also linear operators. Okay, since this is a bit abstract, you probably want to see this in action. So let me give you the power rule for integration, and then using the two, let's solve some questions. Okay. So what is the power rule for derivatives? Power rule for derivatives is if you have x to the nth power, if you differentiate, n comes down, steps down, and you subtract 1. That's the power rule, right? And therefore, powerful integration has to do with doing the opposite. However, as we've probably seen in the previous example, it was more useful to have the antiderivative of x to the n minus 1 rather than this, right? So, let's change the question a little bit and ask, what differentiates to x to the n? Because if we have this, then we have the integration of x to the power of n. So the first thing that we know is that because the order, the exponent drops down by 1, what exponent should it have? If this is n, what should this be? N plus 1 has to be 1 more than n, so that when you differentiate it, it drops down by 1, right? Okay. Now, if you just differentiated this, what are you going to get in front? If you just differentiate this, n plus 1 will step down in front, and you're going to get n, right? But we don't want that, so what do?
N plus 1.
Put a preemptive strike. Let's just put it right there, so that when it steps down, it's going to cancel, it's going to go away, and then you get x to the n. Right. Right. You like that, right?
Can't you put it over something?
You can also write x to the n plus 1 over n plus 1. That's another way to say it. Okay. It's the same thing algebraic. Okay. Now, from this, we know that the integral of x to the n dx is x to the n plus 1, and in front you have to put 1 over n plus 1. Okay, although, oh, and n plus c. Don't ever forget plus c, okay? It'll cost you a point and maybe even more, okay? Don't forget plus c. Alright. Now here, although this is the formula that I'm writing down, to really make use of this formula, you have to understand the formula in a slightly different way than it's written, okay? So the way you're going to understand the formula, try to listen carefully to what I say. If you integrate x to the n, you're supposed to add 1 to the exponent. So maybe I should write it here. Add 1 plus 1. And then, so that would be like step 1. And then step 2 is put the reciprocal of that number in front. So don't think of this as 1 over n plus 1. Think of this as the reciprocal of this number you created. So this is the step 2. Reciprocal of n plus 1. That's the way you're going to think of it. Because, see, here's an example. If you integrate square root of x using the formula, let's think about what happens. Square root is 1 half, isn't it, right? 1 half power is square root. And according to this formula, you have to add 1 to the exponent, so you add 1, 1 half plus 1 is 3 over 2, right? Now, if you simply think of using this formula, if you just simply follow this formula, you're going to get 1 over 3 over 2, because 3 over 2 is n plus 1, right? But when you have 1 over 3 over 2, that requires one extra step of having to flip this over, right? But if you just think of the thing that should be here as reciprocal, what should you write?
2/3.
Just write 2/3. So that saves you one extra thing that you have to do, and it's less confusing that way, okay? So always, when you use the power rule, don't think of this as n plus 1 and put the 1 over n plus 1. No, think of it as n plus 1 and put the reciprocal in front. That's the way you should understand this formula. Okay? All right, and then what did I do? I forgot plus c, right? Plus c, always. Try to remind this. All right, so using this, let's try a problem. After one problem, you probably need to understand what this business is about. It's with the power rule and the linearity. So let's put a question. So example. Compute integral of 3 square root of x plus 5x squared minus 2 dx. Let's try this. Okay, what does the linearity say? Linearity says when you have addition or subtraction, you just integrate part by part. You can break up the complex large question into just several small questions. Okay, so we can just ask 3 square root of x dx plus 5x squared dx plus negative 2 dx. And then, any constant multiple can be brought outside the integral. So I can bring the 3 out. Square root of x is x to the 1 half power. 5 out, x squared dx. Plus negative 2, 1 dx. Okay. And I purposely wrote negative 2 outside and put 1 there because it's easier to find the entire derivative of 1. If you differentiate x, you get 1, right? So this is easy to do. Okay? So let's do one by one. First, add 1, which is 3 over 2, put the reciprocal in front. Same thing again. Add 1 to the exponent, 2 plus 1 is 3, and then you put the reciprocal of 3, 1/3. And then the function that integrates to, differentiates to 1 is x. So you put negative 2x. And then don't forget the plus. Let's simplify. 3, 3 cancels, and you get 2x, 3 over 2, plus 5 over 3, x cubed, minus 2x, plus 6. That is the answer. That's how you use linearity and the power rule together. That already covers a lot of it, a lot of integrals. You can integrate many many things by using this power rule and linearity.